brilliant England women's football team reached the final of the 2022 European Championships by beating Sweden 4-0 last night. Yet this comes off the back of a BBC correspondent questioning the lack of non-white players in the team. Apparently, the success of the team is problematic because all the players are white. Seems the skin colour of the players is more important than their ability to win football matches. This is the natural conclusion of the diversity and inclusion madness, which really just means anti-whiteness. Nothing should have too many white people in it. The less white people, the better. Here's an headline from Sky Sports after England's 1-0 win against Austria in the opening game. England beat Austria 1-0 in the Women's Euro 2022 opener in front of a record 68,871 fans at Old Trafford. England's starting 11 plus the three substitutes that came on were all white, reigniting the debate around the lack of diversity at the elite end of girls and women's football. And here's what a former England women's under 16 player, who happens to be black, said in an article for The Athletic. They don't look like me, it's off-putting. England women and a lack of non-white role models. She then goes on to say, I watch and support England, but for me, the French team, I love it. It's beautiful. That's what football should look like. Why are France able to get it right, but we're struggling when we're such a diverse country? Well, as well as beating Sweden 4-0 in the semi-finals, England, earlier in the tournament, also beat Norway 8-0. Doesn't sound like a team that's struggling to me. Sounds like a team that's getting it absolutely spot on. Now, in case you didn't know, this is a map of England and Northern Europe. It's on the shores of the North Sea in Northern Europe, just across from Denmark. These arrows point to where the people who originally created England came from. Now, the population of the UK is still 84% white, so it's no surprise the England team is mostly white, often with blonde hair and blue eyes. Here's the Ivory Coast's women's football team. What can you see? Yes, you guessed it. There's no diversity to be seen here. And here is the Ghana women's football team. Again, what do you notice? You guessed it. I don't see much diversity in either of these teams. Therefore, this must be a bad thing, regardless of how many football matches they win. And let's be clear, diversity in a team doesn't necessarily mean a less racist society. America has always had lots of black people representing the country in sport, but yet many were second-class citizens that suffered horrendous racism. Muhammad Ali came back from the 1960 Rome Olympics with a winning gold medal in boxing. Then he tried to go get a steak at a local restaurant and he was told no black people were allowed to eat in there. This is the England women's team from 2009. So clearly it has been diverse in the past. Well, if you look, not that diverse because you only ever see white or black players. You never see Asians in the men's or women's team, yet no one ever seems to say anything. So they aren't that bothered about diversity. It only becomes an issue if there's too many white players. Now, in a fair society, some teams might have five black players in it, like the 2019, which would mean they are overrepresented. And in other teams, they may be none. It just depends on who are the best players at that particular time. And in a country that's still 84% white, you'd expect most teams to be predominantly white. Seems some are saying no team should be allowed to be white, even if they happen to be the best players in that team. Now, not supporting your country because they all don't look black like you seems incredibly racist to me. Millions of white Brits cheer on our black countrymen and women all the time. Just look at the Olympics. This is their British women's sprint relay team. Again, what do you see? You guessed it, there's no diversity to be seen here. Should one be taken out of the team and replaced with a white girl to make it more diverse? If this is the best, fastest for British women, then no, obviously not. The idea that little white girls can't look up to these women and want to be sprinters like them because they have a different skin colour is utterly preposterous. And more preposterous still would be complaining that none of the women are white and that this is not allowed because it doesn't hit diversity targets. Yes, equal opportunities for all so the best rise to the top, whoever they may be, whatever their skin colour. And as I've already said, in a country that's 80%, 84% white, you would expect more often than not, the majority who rise to the top would be white. Now, diversity for the sake of diversity should never be the end goal. And it's time we call time on this nonsense. It seems the people behind this have a sinister anti-British, anti-Western and anti-white motives. And the rest have just been brainwashed by this obsession with anti-white diversity as it's now a fashionable mainstream view.